So over the years, I've heard flat earthers make some quite outrageous claims about me. But the other day I read one that is not entirely inaccurate. A flat earther had posted a comment claiming that I have Russian ties. The black one is from Moscow and the other one is from Vladivostok. Over the past few days, I have been testing remote telescope operation for a future project. This is an iPad, but as you can see, we are looking at a Windows operating system. This is on my astronomy laptop in the other room connected to a separate network. But using Chrome Remote Desktop, I can access and control it from an iPad from anywhere in the world. And it works extremely well. So I spent most of yesterday out with family, but in the morning I set up the solar telescope for an all-day time-lapse, and throughout the day, even though I was on the other side of the city, using this system I was able to monitor the progress and watch the sunset as it was seen by the telescope. Let's take a look at the footage. So here is the footage from the telescope, and because it is a hydrogen alpha solar scope, it allows us to see surface detail and also the prominences. I had the camera taking one frame every 2 seconds, and I compiled the time lapse at 30 frames per second. So 1 minute of footage here represents 1 hour of real time. As I fast forward through the video, you can see very clearly the rotation of the sun. Looking at this feature here, and a few spots up in this part of the sun, as I move back and forth, you can see the spherical nature of the sun and the fact that it is rotating. For this time lapse, I compile it as a negative. It allows us to see the prominence a little more clearly, and we can again see these surface features. Moving back and forth through the 7 hours, you can again clearly see the rotation of the sun. There are two additional points worth mentioning here. Firstly, because I'm using an equatorial mount, there is no field rotation in the image all day. And secondly, the camera itself is polar aligned, and that means the direction of up in the picture is the same as the direction of up as it would appear at the North Pole. And that allows us to see the angle of the Earth at south 34 degrees latitude in Sydney as it would appear from the North Pole. When the sun sets, we can see the orientation of the Earth. So to help visualize this point, if we hold a globe with the North Pole directly upwards, you can see that the orientation of the Earth at Sydney, Australia, at south 34 degrees latitude matches what we are seeing in the telescope. So the time lapse goes for over 7 minutes, and it's not that exciting. It's a bit like watching paint dry. So instead of playing it here, I'll place a link in the description below and you can watch it if you choose. And I'll finish off with a short clip for those of us who love aircraft. So now that Emma is older, I let her play with my aeroplane collection. And we're currently working on her aircraft recognition skills. Okay, Emma, where is the MiG? That's right. Where is the Nighthawk? Very good. Where is the Corsair? Excellent. Where is the Sabre? Very good. Where is the Spitfire? Perfect. And where is the Mustang? Okay, one last aircraft. Where is Daddy's aircraft, the Global? Very good. And these are actually all the same scale. So that gives you an idea. That's called a Tomcat, darling.
A Tomcat.
These are all the same scale. So it gives you an idea of how big the Global Express is compared to the other aircraft. Do you like Daddy's aeroplanes? What's your favourite one?
My favourite is the wee
The saber, that is actually heavy. It's all solid metal. Okay, say goodnight to everybody.
Goodnight, everybody.
Okay, Emma. Daddy's going to ask you where I bought these two ties. And you have to say in Russia, okay? Okay, Emma. Where did Daddy buy these ties?
In Kmart.
In Kmart? That's not going to work.